A new guided missile destroyer class is taking shape. The warship of this class, named DDG-X, will slowly replace the Ticonderoga-class guided missile cruisers and older Arleigh Burke-class guided missile destroyers. The U.S. Navy has established a new program office to oversee the development. The office will manage DDG-X's design, technical data package development, construction, testing, fleet introduction, and sustainment plans. As per reports, the goal is to order the first ship in 2028, with an aim to have it in service by 2032. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why the new DDG-X warship of the U.S. Navy will be the most advanced destroyer in the world. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. DDG-X will likely start with the Spy-6 AMDR. That's Air and Missile Defense Radar. The new radar is designed to help ships track missile and aircraft threats at farther ranges while maintaining resilience to noise and other forms of interference. It's estimated to have a 15 dBi improvement compared to the previous generation and Spy-1 radar, or capable of detecting targets half the size at twice the distance. So it's roughly 4 times more powerful. This enables the radar to create a very holistic view of the surrounding, providing an unprecedented situational awareness. Stealth design is mostly attributed to warplanes, but Zumwalt class brought the stealth to a major warship. This knowledge will be implemented in DDG-X. The warships of this class will have significantly reduced radar cross-section. DDG-X will most likely have all-electric propulsion. The platform's next-generation integrated power system will apply lessons the Navy has gleaned from the Ford-class carrier, Zumwalt-class destroyer, and Columbia-class submarine programs, according to a NAVC official. The electric propulsion system has many advantages. The system eliminates the need for the drive shaft and many other heavyweight components. This not only enables easier maintenance, but also reduces the acoustic signature of the warship, making it harder to detect by sonars. The Mark 41 vertical launch system silos in Ticonderoga class and Arleigh Burke-class destroyers can accommodate a lot of weapons. These can be configured with the combination of several types of weapons, like SM-6 for anti-air warfare and anti-ship roll, Tomahawk for land attack, VL-ASROC for anti-submarine operations, ESSM for the anti-missile role, to name a few, but can't accommodate weapons that need larger space, like U.S. Navy's new hypersonic missiles. Hypersonic missiles have the speed of ballistic missiles and maneuverability of cruise missiles, and are almost invulnerable to the current air defense system. The DDG-X will have large silos capable of carrying current weapons packages, as well as new weapons, including hypersonic missiles. Also, since the Ticonderoga class, with its 122 silos, will be decommissioned, it's likely that DDG-X will have more than 100 of these silos. The US Navy is already arming more destroyers with the non-lethal Optical Dazzling Interdictor Navy Odin system, and a stronger laser, the High Energy Laser and Integrated Optical Dazzler and Surveillance Helios, is also being deployed. In the future, more powerful laser weapons will be installed and they'll require more energy. Lasers have some very important advantages. The speed of light enables them to hit their targets almost instantaneously. Laser weapons also don't need to carry ammunition like traditional systems, and hence they'll be able to take out a much larger number of threats, constrained only by the power supply limit of the platform. This is pretty significant, since the warship will not run out of ammunition when encountering a large number of incoming threats. The integrated all-electric power system in DDG-X will provide legroom for laser weapons. Carrie Filling, who leads NAVSEA's Surface Ship Design and Systems Engineering Directorate, said at a conference earlier this year that DDG-X will feature range and miserly fuel consumption, so we're looking at various plants that optimize that, because what we're trying to optimize is time on station. We want that ship to be able to stay forward, stay on station, and be able to deliver ordnance on target. That's one of the things right now that limits us on DDGs. They don't have the legs of the previous cruisers. So we're heavily focused on that and making sure that that ship has the ability to stay on station. While there is no update on the numbers the US Navy wants to achieve when it comes to range and endurance, it can be safely assumed that these will be significantly higher compared to current warships. DDG-X will use extensive automation. For example, the vessels of this class will likely have an automated cargo handling system. This concept has already been executed in Ford-class supercarrier, and the DDG-X will see the implementation of the same principles, though on a smaller scale. The automation reduces the crew complement that's required to run the ship and increases efficiency. This will reduce operational costs and enable accommodation for more goods and weapons in the warship and enable DDG-X to punch much above its weight. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.